President, Mr. Alejandro B. Fernandez, our school directress, Mrs. Philomena B. Fernandez, our school administrator, Mr. Charlie B. Fernandez, our school principal, Dr. Maria Teresa R. Villanueva, our academic coordinators, teachers, parents, friends, and fellow graduates. This day has come when we are now wearing our graduation toga, our most awaited day, seems like an eternity. Just as we share this moment of celebration with you, I would like to express my gratitude, or rather, our gratitude to the people who support us along the way. First, to our parents and guardians, who've given us a lot of support ever since, from the first time we started school until the present, and for many more years. Our parents who sacrificed themselves for their responsibility to provide our needs. There is no such a perfect parent, but you should know that you already have done your best. And as your child, we already saw and appreciate all of your efforts. We may be long stubborns or mga matitigas sa ulo, but giving back a good life to our parents is one of our goals in life. To my parents, Mom and Pam, heaven knows how much you mean to me. I hope that you'll always be by my side to celebrate with me with victories and life's accomplishment. Next to our school, which became our second home, where we met a lot of people and treated us like a family. We first stepped inside the school with no idea what awaits us. But little did I know that lovely memories would be shared here together. Next to our teachers, who serve as our second parent, thank you for your patience and advice. We are grateful for the lessons you taught us about developing our skills in addition to our academic skills. We are thankful for giving your best to help us understand everything that we should and need to learn throughout this high school journey. Next, to our classmates and friends, whom we shared with joy, sorrow, teachers, sermons, and accomplishment. You've been a big part of this journey. As I met you, I knew how to be more confident and enjoy myself in school in spite of everything. The big and small help that we shared together were one of the reasons how I ended up here now. We may go on our separate ways in the future, but the bond that we shared will always be remembered. Of course, to our Almighty God, who given us unconditional guidance and love throughout this life, the one who showered us with blessings and made us stronger every day, the one who truly knows and recognizes whether our hearts were filled with joy or sorrow. He may or may not always grant our wishes and prayers, but we know He always listens and will always be. Finally, how can we feel to express gratitude to ourselves, the one who take up on daily problems? Often, we consider defeat, but we just keep on fighting, do our hardest, and prove ourselves in this life. We should be proud of any big and small achievement that we have. And despite of troubles that we are facing, whether it is financial problem, family problem, or any personal matter, we can still stand on our own. There's this quote by Robert H. Scholar saying, "Today's accomplishment were yesterday's impossibilities." This quote reminds us that every great achievement starts with small steps and overcoming obstacles. Often, we limit ourselves that certain goals or accomplishments are beyond our reach. Thus, this quote reminds and encourages us to adopt a growth mindset, which is to believe that abilities and intelligence can be developed through effort and perseverance. This quote also speaks to our students who thought we couldn't pass and graduate. Since the first day of school, some of us have been anxious whether we can overcome this entire school year. But as the time passed by, we slowly working and moving forward to achieve accomplishment that we desire. These same goals with planning for the future. I know some of us are doubting ourselves, whether we can survive a college or the course that we would like to take. And there's a lot of what they created in our mind, thinking, is it possible? Or is it possible for me, impossible for me to achieve the dream that I am aiming for? There's a lot of what if and troubles that we are thinking. But if you feel like giving up on something, think back again of the reason why you started it in the first place. I guess there is impossibilities, it's a distraction. But accomplishment should be your motivation. But again, as a quote says, today's accomplishment for yesterday's impossibilities. Let's dream with action, and not just a dream that is full of thoughts. Nothing is impossible. As the world itself says, I'm possible. As the artists of our own dream, we hold the power to create our dream into reality, using our imagination and action to create a masterpiece of our own design. Stop degrading and doubting yourselves. If you can't even trust yourself, how can even other people trust you? First, believe in yourself and believe in our Almighty God who has bigger and better plans for us. Today is not the end, but the beginning. As we are not worthy picking the road that will shape us, who will we become in the future? The road that we must take in order to be our better selves and not be disheartened at the end of the day. As we step to the next chapter of our lives, let's not forget the values and principles that have guided us this far. Let honesty, kindness, and empathy serve as a compass that guides our behavior. Never be scared to take chances. Together, we can make a positive impact on this world. Once again, congratulations and best of luck to the batch of 2023 and 2024.
Of grade 12 class to give her speech of gratitude.